First, let's start with absorption costing. Absorption costing is a costing technique which was introduced in traditional manufacturing environment in which direct cost was more significant than indirect cost. This resulted because of more use of direct labor than machines. Absorption costing absorbs overheads using three stages. Stage number one is allocation. Stage number two is apportionment. Stage number three is absorption. So now, let's understand the process of absorption costing for absorbing overheads using three stages through a very good, easy to understand diagram. Now, let's assume that the overheads for an organization are $20,000. So remember, these are also known as indirect cost. Now, these are the production overheads for an organization, and that particular organization has three departments, for example. So the first is production department 1, second is service department 1, and third is production department 2. So the first thing is allocation. These $20,000 will be allocated to these departments. So what is allocation? Allocation is a process through which directly attributable overheads are charged to cost centers like production department 1, service department 1, and production department 2 are the cost centers. So these overheads will now be charged to these cost centers. Now let's take a very easy to understand example. For example, there are two friends. And two friends are very hungry, so they went to a burger chain. They ordered 5 burgers. Once the order came, one of the friend ate 4 burgers and the other friend just ate 1 burger. Then the bill came. So the friend who ate 4 burgers suggested that we should share this cost equally. Is this fair? Not at all. Why? Because the friend who ate 4 burgers is responsible to bear the cost of 4 burgers. So in terms of allocation, the 4 burger cost should be charged or allocated to the friend who ate 4 burgers. And the friend who just ate 1 burger should be allocated the cost of 1 burger. Now, let's take one more example that pertains to an organization. For example, there are 2 supervisors. One supervisor is responsible for production department 1, earning a salary of $1,000. Another supervisor is responsible for production department 2. Earning a salary of $2,000. So, the cost of the first supervisor should be allocated because this is directly pertaining to production department 1. Will be charged to production department 1. And the cost of the second supervisor should be allocated to production department 2. So, this is basically allocation. Now, after understanding the first concept of allocation, now let's move towards the second concept of apportionment. So, what is apportionment? As all the common cost, other than the cost that have been allocated directly to the departments, will now be shared between these cost centers. So apportionment is a process that shares the common cost between the cost centers. But yes, it is important to remember that the basis of apportionment should be fair. Examples of common cost includes rent, utilities, as these are the expenses which are incurred by all the departments. Example of the fair basis includes the apportionment should be made on the basis of, for example, square meters or number of employees, etc. So, the second stage, as I mentioned here, is apportionment. Now, after allocation and apportionment have been done to all these three departments, means that all the overheads are now charged to these departments. Now, here, one question arises. Here, one is a service department. So, the overheads that have been charged to service departments are the one that should be recharged to the production departments. And this gives rise to the concept of reapportionment of overheads. Now, let's understand why reapportionment is actually required. So, it's quite easy to understand. As service department, for example, this is a canteen, is providing services to the production department. So, as it is providing services to the production department, these costs should be charged to the production department, because service department is providing services to these production department. That is why the cost should be charged back to the production department. Once the reapportionment has been done, so all the overheads now are in production department, that is production department 1 and production department 2. So then comes the third stage, and that is absorption. So all these overheads now will be absorbed into the products, and this stage is stage of absorption. Now, in this third stage of absorption, it is very, very important to remember that this third stage of absorption requires the calculation of OAR. Now, what is OAR? OAR is overhead absorption rate. So, for the purpose of absorbing overheads into product, you need to absorb the overheads into the product cost. For that, you need to work out OAR. So, what is the formula to calculate OAR? The formula is budgeted overheads divided by budgeted activity levels. So, through this formula, you absorb the overheads into product cost. Now, you have covered in your previous management accounting course that there are different types of activity levels. So, this is what you need to remember. So, let's recall how many types of activity levels were covered in paper management accounting. So, the first very common basis that is used is direct labor hours. The second very common basis that is used is machine hours. Then the third is number of units. So these are the common bases that are used. Along with these three, there are three other bases: percentage of direct labor cost, percentage of material cost, percentage of prime cost. So these are the six bases which are normally used for absorbing the overheads into product cost. Now, these six bases are known as production related activity level. So these six basically are known as production related activity level. Now the question comes, why these are called as production related activity level? So it's very simple to understand. If the organization produces one more unit or one extra unit, so that one extra unit will require additional labor hours and additional material. So as one unit requires additional labor hours and additional material, which means these are the resources which are directly connected with the production or the volume. As these are directly connected with the production or the volume, that is why we call these production related activity levels. So it is very important to remember that these are production related just because as one additional unit is produced, the resources in form of direct labor and material will further be required. That is why known as volume based or production related activity levels. So I hope this entire diagram of process costing stages will make it clear for you to understand the process of absorption costing, and you will easily recall the basics that you have learned in your previous course, Management Accounting. It's time now to move towards activity-based costing.